G'day, this is Matt Cornell from Cornell Engineers. Today I'm answering one of the questions we get quite frequently, and that's, do we at Cornell Engineers do inspections and provide reports for people who are selling their house? So Tom, for example, was selling his house, noticed cracks in the walls, thought that it might be a good idea to get an engineer's report before he puts the house on the market so that he can show the engineer's report to prospective buyers and allay their fears. Now, while this sounds like a good idea in theory, what we have found is that most buyers do not trust the seller's engineer's report. So in fact, Tom, if he were to engage us so that he could sell his house or to provide a report before he sells his house, is probably just wasting his time and his money, because the first buyer that comes along, or the buyer that comes along, is more than likely going to read the report, not trust it, think that it's been provided for the seller, for the seller's benefit, and then go out and get his own report. The fact is, engineers should be writing reports independently of who is paying them, but that theory, or that feeling that people are worried that they can't rely on the engineer's report, that's a real concern. So our solution is, instead of Tom coming to us before he sells the house, or as he's preparing the house for sale, we recommend just about every time that Tom and the buyer, once he has a contract, engage the engineer, engage Cornell Engineers if you prefer, together, that the buyer attend the engineer's inspection with the engineer, ask any questions that they feel like they would like answered, have their name on the engineer's report when it's issued, even though Tom is maybe even paying 50% or 100% of the report. It allays the buyer's fears. It becomes the buyer's report, or it helps the buyer feel more satisfied that the engineer has done a good job and is acting for both parties, and it allows the buyer to ask the questions that they want. Now, don't forget, we also recommend that most buyers undertake a building and pest report. On our website, we've talked about this. There's building and pest reports, even for me, are a valuable resource, and when I purchase properties, most times we tend to get a building and pest inspection report as well. So it's that good. Definitely recommend using a building and pest inspector. We have attended site inspections with the building and pest inspector, but more often than not, it's a better value for money if the engineer attends to inspect a building after the building and pest inspector has been, to answer any questions that remain. Building and pest inspectors are required, or tend to, in any case, have a lot of recommendations to seek specialist advice, and a lot of the time that it tends to be a structural engineering advice. So we'd normally recommend that a building and pest inspection is done first, and then if there are any structural issues that are raised in that report, that then you go out and you get your structural engineering report at that time. All right, so this has been Matt Cornell from Cornell Engineers. Hope this has clarified our feeling, or the best way we think you could spend your money on an engineer's report if you're buying or selling a house. We're based in Brisbane. We're working all across the state, and at the moment, in fact, I'm coming back from Stradbroke Island. So we get around. Give us a call if we can help you, and we'll see what we can do for you. Matt Cornell from Cornell Engineers. See ya.